Rizchik. I've never heard that name in my whole life.
Oh, God. Yes, you've heard it. You just didn't bother to remember it, did you? Do you know, I remember the first time I said my last name around you, Jack. I was waiting for... nothing. You couldn't even bother to remember the name of the woman that you got pregnant. Okay, Gwen, why are you so sure that Jack is your father? Do you have any proof? Yes, because as long as I can remember, I heard my mother cursing him out, cursing the name of the man who ruined her life.
She may have believed that to be true, but... she never told me.
Bloody liar. Don't you lie. Yes, she did. You know damn well that she did. The hell you want? I have nothing to hide. No? Oh, so does he know about your days as a hooker? As a homewrecker? That you tried to kill your ex, Victor Kiriakis, with a fireplace poker? Or your ex's ex, Chloe Lane, with a poison brownie? Guess not.
Why the hell are you doing this, Gabby?
Because Kate hasn't filled you in, and I think a person's past is important to how they will react in the present and the future, too. So let's keep it going. Drum roll, please. This is actually the showstopper. Your girl, Kate, happened to have the Kiriakis mansion set on fire and tried to kill her son.
It wasn't intentional, Gabby, and I didn't know Lucas was in the house.
Do you see the pattern? This is what happens to her exes. I mean, the longest relationship she's ever... Let's just say you are bound to be her ex. Jake, it's inevitable. I'm just saying, watch your back.
That's not what Gwen said. Gwen said that your dad turned his back on her and her mom.
Well, it's not true. I know my dad.
Okay, but... I mean, your dad did walk out on your mom and you and JJ, right?
God, I just need to talk to him, and I need to see if it's true. I don't. That woman cannot be my sister after everything she has done to me.
There's something else that you need to know.
Once upon a time, and she told you all about me.
Look, I swear to you, to both of you, that never happened.
Yes, but it did. I remember it. I was just a little girl. But I remember all of it. We were down to our last can of baked beans, and, we were about to be evicted from our crappy flat in Peoria. My mum said she was going to swallow her pride and she was going to come beg for your help. So, she brought me to Salem and she shoved me in this cockroach-infested motel room that she found, and she just went and spoke to you. Came back crying. Said that you didn't want to speak to her. You were too busy with your wife and your daughter, your precious little princess, Abigail. You didn't even want to meet me.
Your mother was lying.
No, she was not lying. You had your secretary send her money each month to keep her quiet.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. You know you did. Okay, okay.